Hello friends, welcome to Alankar Pharmacy classes again. In the today's class, I am going to tell you about the flash distillation. This is my third video in distillation series, that is of steam distillation, then distillation under reduced pressure, and this is the third topic relating to distillation. So without wasting our time, let's start. Now this flash distillation is also known as equilibrium distillation. This is because the separation is performed here, that is on the basis of equilibrium between liquid and vapor phases. Now let us come to its principal part. When the hot liquid enters suddenly from the high pressure zone to low pressure zone, the whole liquid converts into vapor suddenly, and this is known as flash vaporization. In this flash vaporization, all of the liquid will suddenly converts into vapor because it is moved from the high pressure area to low pressure area and it is heated also. So there will be a flash vaporization, and in this flash vaporization, what will happen? The high boiling point fraction of the vapors will convert into liquid, or it will condensed very soon, and but the low boiling point fraction remains in a vapor form. So in this way, liquid and vapor, or low boiling point fraction and the high boiling point fraction of any feed, can be separated out. Now the vapors and liquid were kept in equilibrium for some time because this process of separation took some time. So that's why the process takes some time. The liquid part is collected separately and the vapors can be condensed at different place. So this is the principle of this method. Now let us move to the equipment part of this flash distillation. In this equipment, it consists of a pump connected to the feed reservoir. Here is the pump and this is the feed reservoir, to introduce the liquid into the heat chamber. Here is the heating chamber. Now heated liquid passes through the pressure reducing valve. So liquid is heated by this heater and it passes through the pressure reducing valve. Here it is shown in a PRV because of the lack of space. So this is the pressure reducing valve, then and introduced into vapor liquid separator. So this is the vapor liquid separator. Now vapor outlet at the top, the vapor outlet is at the top and the liquid outlet is at the bottom of this vapor liquid separator. So this is the equipment part of this method. Now let us come to the working part, how it works. Now the feed is pumped into heating chamber with pressure. Here is the feed, and feed pumps the liquid into the heater with pressure. Now the heated liquid enters the vapor liquid separator, pressure reducing valve, and there is all of a sudden flash of the liquid. Here there is a flash of the liquid which enhances the vapor formation and cooling effect. When the liquid is vaporized in such a manner, there will be a cooling effect also because of the all of a sudden vaporization of any kind of such liquid. So in this way, there will be all of a sudden cooling effect also. Thus, the high boiling point fraction condensed into liquid, that we have already discussed, condensed into liquid, but low boiling point fraction remains into vapor form. Equilibrium may take some time and the vapors are separated and liquid collected from the bottom. So liquid will be collected from bottom and the vapors can be moved to somewhere else where they can be condensed to convert into liquid form or any other product. So this may be a continuous operation, and where the pump continuously feed the liquid inside the this vapor liquid separator, and there will be a continuous formation of our product. So this is one of its advantages also. Now let us come to its advantages, disadvantages and uses. The first advantage that we have already discussed, that is its continuous operation. Now another advantage is that it's relatively simple and inexpensive equipment. So this is the one of the very good advantage of this kind of method. Now there are few disadvantages also. The first disadvantage that it is having a low yield. Now another disadvantage, it is not suitable when the pure components is required, because this method is a not a very efficient separating method. That's why this is the one of its disadvantage, that we cannot get the purest form of any substance through this method. Now there are some uses of flash distillation. What are they? The first is the recovery of aroma from fruit juices or deodorization. This is its first use. Now another thing is that is the refining of crude oil. The flash distillation is used heavily by the refineries for the refining of the crude oils. Now third thing is the separating the component with wide difference in boiling point. For example, petroleum ether. So this for separating such kind of components, flash distillation is used. And the last its use is the desalination of the seawater. Some of the Gulf countries are still using this technique for desalination of seawater, and in this case what will happen, the salt mixed with water will be settles down here in the still, and the vapor which is actually the pure form of water without any salt is vaporized, that will be condensed later on and convert into pure water that can be used for other purposes also. So this is the uses of this flash distillation. So what we have discussed so far, first of all the principle, then equipment, then the working, advantages, disadvantages and the uses. So this is all with flash distillation. Hope you all have liked my video. So please do share this flash distillation topic with your colleagues who are in the search of this topic. And if you want me to make a video on any specific topic, then please drop your message in the comment section below. I will try to make videos on your suggested topic also. So thank you friends. Thank you.